So, hi all. Today we will see this question. Clone a linked list with next and random pointer. So, see, you are given a special linked list with n nodes, where each node has a next pointer pointing to its next node. You are given m random pointers, where you will be given m number of pairs denoting two nodes A and B. Construct a copy of the given list. The copy should consist of exactly n new nodes, where each new node has its value set to the value of its corresponding original node. Both the next and the random pointer of the new node should point to the new nodes in the copied list, such that the pointer in the original list and copy list represent the same list state. None of the pointer in the new list should point to the nodes in the original list. Okay, so let us understand this using a test case. So see, I have this test case. In this test case, I have given the number of nodes 4. So these are my nodes 1, 2, 3 and 4. And this is given that this is a special kind of a linked list. That is, it's a kind of a doubly linked list. Like in doubly linked list, we have two fields. One field to show the next reference and another to show the previous reference. Similarly, the structure for this node in this linked list is data. Then I have arbitrary address and then I have next address. So the structure for a node in this linked list looks like this. So see, let me just create a large linked list. So this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, and this is 4. So the next of this is pointing to 2. The next of 2 is pointing to 3. The next of 3 is pointing to 4. And the next of 4 is null. And also, we are given m pairs. That represents the arbitrary node. That is, 1 points to 2 and 2 points to 4. And for all the nodes that I have not given the arbitrary pointers, that means they are pointing to null. So let us fill this. So arbitrary pointer for 1 is 2. That is, 1 is pointing to 2 and 2 is pointing to 4. And all that I have not given is null. That is, the arbitrary pointer for 3 and 4 is null. And now what the task that I have to perform is that I have to clone this linked list. That is, I have to create a copy of this linked list. And it is clearly mentioned that while copying, the data should be the same. The copied linked list should have exactly the same number of nodes as the original linked list. And the next and reference next and arbitrary pointer should also be the same. Mention that none of the pointers should point the nodes in the original linked list. That is, they should be pointing to the nodes of the copied linked list only. So see, basically what we can do is, we can simply create a hash map. So if we create a hash map stores the key value pair. And let me say the key is of a node type and the value is also a node type. The key stores the original nodes and the value stores the nodes of copied linked list. So see, what I want to do is, for every node in the linked list, I will create one new node. That would be my copy node. And I will point this original node to that copy node in the hash map. That is, let me create the copy node for this one. And in that copy node, I will only copy the data as of now. So the key would be original one. And the value would be copy one. That is, the मैप ऑफ ओरिजिनल वन स्टोर्स द कॉपी वन. ओरिजिनल वन इज दिस नोड एंड कॉपी वन इज अ न्यू नोड दैट आई एम मेकिंग वे आई एम ओनली स्टोरिंग द डेटा एज ऑफ नाउ. एंड लेट अस डू फॉर ऑल ऑफ द नोड्स दैट इज ओरिजिनल टू वुड पॉइंट टू कॉपी टू ओरिजिनल थ्री वुड पॉइंट टू कॉपी थ्री एंड ओरिजिनल फोर वुड पॉइंट टू कॉपी फोर. नाउ आफ्टर दिस वी हैव क्रिएटेड ऑल द कॉपीज. नाउ द टास्क दैट इज रिमेनिंग इज टू पॉइंट एंड टू लिंक द कंप्लीट लिंक लिस्ट. सो वॉट कैन वी डू, वी कैन स्टार्ट आर इटरेशन फ्रॉम दिस नोड एंड वॉट वी कैन डू, द कॉपीड लिंक लिस्ट वुड बिगेन विद द मैप ऑफ दिस लिंक लिस्ट. That is, what value does I have in the map of 1? That is, copy 1. So, using that, I will have the access to this node. And as I have said, I have already stored the data for a node. And now the task is to store the next and end arbitrary pointer. So, see, what would be its next? Its next would be the same as the next of the original linked list. So, the next of the original one is 2. So I will be at this node. Now if I will simply write that the copy of 2 is copied node next is original node next, then in this I will get the access to the original node only. But it is clearly mentioned that none of the pointers should point to a node in the original linked list. Now, for this, I have already mapped a copied linked list with this. So, instead of this, we will write copied next would point to map of original next. Okay. So, using that, my next for 1 would be the 2. And this 2 is the copied node. And similarly for the arbitrary node, I will write map of original nodes arbitrary. That is, the arbitrary for the original node is pointing to 2. So, I will be having this. But I will also write the hash map. So using hash map, I will have the access to this copied node. So it will point to this. So let us see using the code so that it will get more clear to you. See, so this is the pointer to traverse the original linked list. And this is the pointer that I will be accessing to access the copied linked list. So here I have created a map and named it as my map. Now, while my original linked list exists, what I'm doing, I'm creating a node and only copying the data that I have already told. And now, in the hash map for the original linked list, I'm storing this new node. And now I'm just updating my current pointer. And using this, we will construct the copy nodes for every original node, and we will also construct a hash map for every node. Now after this, the task is to link the list. So I'm initializing the current with the head, that is, I'm again traversing the linked list till it exists. So what I'm doing, so the clone linked list would be the hash map for original linked list. Its next would be the value at originals next. Its arbitrary would be the value at originals arbitrary, and I would simply update it and I would return the map of head. Why am I returning the map of head and not head? Because if I return the head, then I would be returning this original linked list, which will ultimately print this list only. And now I am returning the map of head. This will return this copy one, which will eventually print this copied linked list. So this was about it, but what is the time complexity and the space complexity? So see, the time complexity is linear. because I'm doing two traverses, so it would be big of n plus n, that is big of n. And what would be its space complexity? It would be big of n as I'm using this hash mark. But the expected time complexity and space complexity didn't fulfill because we have to solve this in constant space. So let us see how can we solve this in constant space. So see, what we will do. See, if I have to create the copy, then I have to construct the nodes. So let us say I am creating the copy for this node 1. I have stored the data. In the next field, I am storing whatever the next I have for this. The next for this is 2. So in the next of this copy linked list also, I am storing this 2 only. But now since I have referenced its next to 2, so I have to change the reference for this node. So what I will do, The next for this original 1 would point to this copied linked list now. That is, they are not linked now. Okay. Similarly, now let us create the copied node for this 2. So this is my node 2. What would be its next? Whatever the next I had for this, which would be 3. And after this, I will change the next for this. And now, the next for this will be this. That is what I am doing now, is I am inserting the new nodes in between the current and the next node. Let us make another node. 3. The next would point to 4. We will change this next to this. And similarly for the last node, I'm creating this copied node. The next would point to the next that I had for this. Will not point now, and the next for the original one would be the copy. So basically, what is this linked list doing? I'm inserting another node in between the original linked list, and I have changed the next fields. So whatever the next field I had for the original linked list is now the next field for the copied linked list, and now the original linked list is pointing to the node of the copied linked list. Now the thing is to references the arbitrary pointers. So let us now reference the arbitrary pointers. See, for arbitrary pointer, there are two cases. Either it exists or it doesn't exist. So first we have to check if it exists, that is, if it is not null. So if it is not null, then suppose the arbitrary pointer for 1 is 2. Arbitrary pointer for 1 is 2. So what we can do is, we can simply make its arbitrary pointer to this node. That is, see, arbitrary for node 1 was 2. And now in the copied linked list, if I write in the copied node, if I write the arbitrary of copy would be the arbitrary of original, then eventually I would be having the original node only. But in the copy linked list, I want the copy nodes. Therefore, the arbitrary for the copy node would be arbitrary next of the original. That is, whatever I was having for the original linked list, now it's my arbitrary pointer for the copied linked list. So, arbitrary pointer for the node 2 was 4. So now arbitrary pointer for 2 will be copied node 4. Arbitrary pointer for node 3 was null and for 4 was null. And now दिस ऑल इज अकरिंग इन अ सिंगल लिंक लिस्ट. नाउ द टास्क इज टू सेपरेट बोथ ऑफ दिस लिंक लिस्ट एंड नाउ आई विल सिंपली सेपरेट दिस लिंक लिस्ट एंड रिटर्न द हेड ऑफ दिस न्यू लिंक लिस्ट. सो दैट इज इम्प्लीमेंटेड यूजिंग कोड एंड देन आई विल ड्राई रन दिस अप्रोच सो दैट इट कुड बी अ बेटर पिक्चर फॉर यू. So let us now code it. So I have to traverse this linked list. So let us take one variable, current, that will traverse this linked list. And while current is not null, what we will do, we will simply create the new node, copy, and we will copy the value. And after this, we will just change the fields. Copy next will become the current next. And now the current next will become the copy. And after this, we will simply update. I will dry run this, don't worry. After this, we have second traversal. Where we are storing the arbitrary pointers. So while current is not null, what will we do if current's arbitrary is not null? Then we will simply update the arbitrary to the arbitrary next. Then after this, updating the current, and after this we can simply update our current and we can simply separate both of these linked lists. So I have to create basically the head of copy linked list. Initially let's say null. And the tail for copy linked list. Now while current exists, that I'm doing third time traversal, it will simply say if our copy head is null, that is till now we don't have any element in the copied linked list, then we will simply update our copy head with the current next and the copy tail with the current next. Else if we already have some existing nodes, then we will only have to update the tail. It will be current next and simply updating the tail. Copy tail is copy tail next. And after this, so in this I am maintaining the copy linked list, and for the original linked list what I have to do, I have to update the current pointer. So the current next is current next next and updating the iteration. Let us see if it passed all the test cases. Oh, I haven't returned anything. Just let us return the head of the copy linked list. And after this, we will dry run this. Wait, we have done some mistake. So here I was creating the current and I have traversed it, created a node copy which has the value for current data. Now copy next is pointing to current next is copy and current is current's next to next. Now the current is head while it's not null. changing its arbitrary if it exists. Next arbitrary is arbitrary next. And now after this, okay, we have to update it twice. Let's submit it. So yeah, the problem is successfully solved, and let us now dry run this. So see, now we will dry run this and it will get easy for you. We will dry run it from the scratch. So see, first let us create the linked list. So I have one, we have its arbitrary, we have its next. The next is pointing to 2. The next of this is 3. And the next of this is 4. And this is null. And let us now make all the arbitraries. So 1 arbitrary is pointing to 2. And 2's arbitrary is pointing to 4. And 3 and 4 arbitrary is null. Now we have to create a copy linked list. So what is the first step that we have done? See, in the first step, what we have done, we have iterated towards our linked list and we have created a copy node and we have updated the data for that field and we have created its next pointer. So see, we have constructed a node, we have copied the data, and now what we have done is copy next is current next. So right now my current is at this. So what is the current's next? 2. So the copy next is current next, which is 2. And after this, so see, we have created a copy node. The copy next is current's next, we have constructed. Now the current next is copy, current is pointing at this node, its next would be the copy, which is this, and current is current's next. That is, right now my current was at this position. What would be its current's next? It would be this copied node. And what would be its next? This original node. So now the current is at this. Basically, in the iteration, after the one, I want to traverse the second node. Therefore, to skip one node, we are doing next of next. Now, what we will do, we will construct another node 2. So, the copy next is current's next. So, what is the current's next? 3. Current's next is copy. So, now the current's next is copy. This was there, okay. And now after this, current is current next to next. Now the current will point to 3. Now after this, I am creating another copy node. For the node 3. Copy next would be current's next. So current's next is 4. So the next would be at 4. And current next is copy. So now it will point to this copy node. The current is current next to next. So now the current is at this. So we are creating another copy node, which is this 4. Copies next is current's next. So it is pointing to null. And this is pointing to this. Now after this, we have to build all the arbitrary pointers. Let us see the code for the arbitrary pointer. This was the code for the arbitrary pointer. See what we are doing. Initially the current is at head, that is we are again starting our iteration from the head. We are at this position. So while the current is not null, see, if the current arbitrary is not null, that is if it's arbitrary exists. So is it exist? Yes, the arbitrary is at 2. What we'll do, current's next arbitrary, so this is the current node, its next is this arbitrary would be current's arbitrary is next. So the current node was 1. What is the arbitrary for current node? This is this second node. And what is the next for this node is this copied node. So now the arbitrary for this is pointing to, now the current is at current's next to next, that is now the current is at this position. So if the arbitrary point exists for this, yes. So what we'll do, current's next arbitrary would be current's arbitrary's next, that is this. Okay, and the current is current's next to next, that is now the current is at third node. And after this, does it arbitrary exist? No. So the current is current's next to next, arbitrary exists? No, it is null now. We will stop. Now the task is to separate both of these two linked lists. So what we will do, we will make this now. See, I have these nodes. First is copy head. So this is copy head. I have this copy tail. And I have a node current. So initially my copy head is null. My copy tail is null. And the current is pointing to head. So while current is not null, if copy head is null, yes. So what we'll do, we'll simply do copy head is current's next. So what is the current head? What is the next of head? This is the copy one. So now the copy head is pointing to copy one. Copy tail is current's next. This is also pointing to copy one. And after this, current's next is current's next to next. It is now the current is pointing to next of next, that is original 2. Now, while, and now the current is at this original 2. So now while current is not null, if copy head is null, no, we'll see else condition. Copy tail next, we now will update this next. Copy tail now is pointing to current's next. So what is current? Original 2. What is the next of original 2? Copy 2. And now simply updating our copy tail. Now the copy is at this now. And now after this, we will update our current next to the current's next to next, which is current's next is copy 2. Its next is original 3. So now the current will point to original 3. Now, is it null? No. So what we'll do? If copy head is null, no. So we'll simply do
कॉपी टेल नेक्स्ट इज करेंट्स नेक्स्ट. सो व्हाट इज करेंट ओरिजिनल थ्री, व्हाट इज इट्स नेक्स्ट कॉपी थ्री. सो दिस इज नाउ पॉइंटिंग टू कॉपी थ्री एंड नाउ द कॉपी टेल इज एट दिस पोजिशन एंड नाउ विल सिंपली अपडेट आर करेंट टू करेंट नेक्स्ट नेक्स्ट. सो इनिशियली द करेंट इज एट दिस, सो द नेक्स्ट ऑफ करेंट इज दिस एंड इट्स नेक्स्ट इज दिस. सो वी आर एट ओरिजिनल फोर एंड नाउ द करेंट इज एट दिस पोजिशन ओरिजिनल फोर. सो इफ कॉपी हेड इज नल, नो, देन विल सिंपली अपडेट आर कॉपी टेल नेक्स्ट टू करेंट नेक्स्ट. सो वॉट इज द नेक्स्ट ऑफ ओरिजिनल फोर? Copy 4 and now the copy tail is at this position and now the current next is current next to next. So original 4's next is copy 4 and this next is null. So this is now null and now the current is pointing at null position. So current is null, so we will not go inside the loop and we will terminate and we are returning the copy head. So using this copy 1 and all the accesses we have here, we have the copy list and original linked list separated. So this was all about it. The time complexity would be big of n and space complexity would also be big of 1 because we are not using any auxiliary space. So that was all about it. If you have any doubt, feel free to comment. Thank you.